Bart Palaszewski, 26 years of age, 5'9", 155, a 70-inch reach. His opponent, Anthony Pettis, 5'10", 155, and a 72-inch reach. Great fight for you, folks. We know inside the cage, Joe Martinez has the official introductions.
And here we go, fight fans. Three rounds scheduled. This in the lightweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, he is a mixed martial artist. Standing 5 feet 10 inches tall, his official weight, 155 pounds. He enters the cage tonight unblemished as a professional. 7 victories with no defeats. Fighting out of his hometown and representing Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Here is the undefeated Anthony Showtime. Next is opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. His style, Muay Thai and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Standing 5 feet 9 inches tall, he too weighed in 155 pounds. A veteran inside the cage, he brings 31 victories, 13 defeats, and joins us tonight from Wonder Lake, Illinois. Here is Bart Bartimus Palaszewski. Referee in charge of the action, Steve Mazzucchetti.
All right, gentlemen, let's give us a good, clean, fair fight. Obey my commands. Protect yourself at all times. And hook them up.
Good luck.
Not much of a hookup there.
Well, I'm starting to
all right.
Partial torso.
We're set to go in the lightweight division. Anthony Pettis taking on Bart Palaszewski. This one's scheduled for three rounds.
Come on.
Steve Mazzucchetti, our referee. Wow, the speed right off the bat of Pettis.
Nice footwork and movement. I mean, hands down is a little cocky, but, you know. But obviously he knows his... Oh, wow. Never mind. Sorry, Anthony, you can do whatever you want, bro.
The range, Frank, I mean, the speed and the range this kid has is unbelievable.
Oh, my God.
And I guess when you're that fast, you don't need to put your hands up. Plenty
hands
of time.
Skilled. He's using great footwork also to go ahead and cover the... That's his defense at this point. Footwork and head movement. By moving around... Was that an axe kick? Well, that was an axe kick. And it almost actually landed. You know, hit him on the shoulder. That's a lot of Korean arts, Taekwondo.
Good exchange, though. Palaszewski not backing down. Remember, this is a guy who's had 45 professional fights, so Palaszewski's probably seen it all. Speed, power... Axe kick, maybe not.
Yeah, and he's been in there with the likes of, Anthony Giovanni, so he's seen speed before. Oh!
Spinning back fist coming from Pettis, showing the full repertoire, the young man from Milwaukee. Palaszewski's had enough of that, he's going to lock him up.
He's got a nice body lock there, double underhooks locked up. Looking to go ahead and get a takedown.
Don't hold that cage, Anthony.
I think he's already seen enough of the stand-up to realize, let's go ahead and find out where we're at on the ground. Which is, again, just crazy, too, because talking to, Duke Rufus and Pat Barry from his camp in his corner, for as good as he is on his feet, they say that he's super impressive on the ground when it comes in the gym.
Under 3 minutes to go here in round number one. This one's scheduled for three. Bart Palaszewski in the white trunks. Anthony Pettis in the black and white.
He's got to be careful now. Anthony Pettis has a kimura locked on the wrist of Bart. If he ends up throwing him and not paying attention, nice elbow. He could easily get put into a submission here. Henzo Gracie a la Sakuraba style.
Pettis taking his time.
Well, he's safe from his neck being attacked. Yeah.
There it is. He called it, Frank.
And he's going to switch off to an arm bar now. To a knee bar.
Oh, wow.
That was really a deep one.
Hold the fence, Bert.
And he can still go for a heel hook here. Watch. Sinks the feet under the hips. He's working for the heel hook right now. Bob Palaszewski tells him he's seen it, defended it. He was able to pull out. Explosive combination of submission attempts, but Bart Palaszewski training with Jeff Curran, a great black belt by his own right. easily, you know, identified those submissions, was able to stay safe.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
I've seen that technique done in practice. I've never seen anybody pull it off with that kind of explosion before.
Inadvertent low kick to Anthony Pettis, so at the discretion of our referee, Steve Mazzagatti, can have up to 5 minutes to walk this off.
That was completely unintentional, because Pawlicewski was just throwing a kick to the legs, and Anthony Pettis is just so fast that he actually put himself in that position. That was a good thing that Bart Pawlicewski was throwing that strike, though. Had he not thrown that and landed, who knows how much more he would have, Anthony Pettis would have had on that kick.
Pettis trying to work all out, says he's ready to go. Mazzagatti asked him, gives him the green light. Back to fighting.
All right.
Wow. Impressive. He faked low with his whole body like he was going to go for some type of takedown, and was able to come over the top of the roundhouse.
Pawlicewski now coming forward. Don't sleep on the kicks of Bart Pawlicewski.
Pawlicewski's had that was a nice check hook.
A little mimicking there. Do you really want to go there, Frank Mir? Do you really want to do that?
This is one of those things where the results will justify the means.
Pawlicewski now gaining confidence. Going almost a full round with Anthony Pettis in the speed. And I think this is where he's going to benefit the most. If he can get him into a body lock up against the cage, limits his speed, his attack.
Absolutely agree with that. I wouldn't want to really have to be fighting Anthony Pettis on the outside here. Uh-oh.
Go ahead and take the back if he's going to give it to him. Pettis has done that. How much trouble is he in here?
That's 15 seconds left. Not a lot. In fact, wouldn't be surprised if Anthony Pettis does a front flip to kind of slam Bart's head into the mat. Oh, wow. Well, it didn't slam his head in the mat, but it was a nice front roll.
And round number one will come to a conclusion. We'll see a second round. Where do we start here, Frank? Let's go back to round number one. We saw all kinds of creativity, shall we say.
Here's a beautiful roundhouse. You know, Bart Pawlicewski barely slipped it off the shoulder. Here he goes for a Superman punch, but pushed off the fence to throw a right hand. Here, another hand combination. You see the spinning. And it wasn't really even just a blind technique. You see guys throw that technique all the time blindly. Here, the Kimura, he almost was able to roll up the top, but Bart Pawlicewski was able to roll through quickly.
Right.
And here was able to also now defend the new attempt on his arm. And look at the leg attack there. Oh, that was great job.
And then he went to the heel hook. I mean, he threw it all at it.
He was. And you know what? Compliment to Bart Pawlicewski for not being caught in one of those submission attempts.
So we're set for round number two. Anthony Pettis taking on Bart Pawlicewski. Give credit to Bart Pawlicewski. He's seen just about everything you can in a round. Anthony Pettis threw all the tricks at him, all kinds of different moves, attacking from different angles. And this is one thing you just can't coach, the speed that Pettis has in that jab.
But you could break it down, and I agree with what Bart Pawlicewski is doing right now. He's attacking the legs, throwing roundhouses low. That will slow down Anthony Pettis' ability, because either A, he eats the kick, which will throw him off, or B, he has to lift his leg up to check it. Or completely jump out of the way of it, I guess, plan C, which all in all is good for Bart Pawlicewski.
Those kicks are vicious.
Bart needs to come out to jab inside kick, jab cross outside kick. He needs to be working the roundhouses and breaking down his opponent. And that will be the difference to be able to make up for the fact of speed. Nice, he faked the kick. He'll be able to get a takedown and now end up in a top position on top of Anthony Pettis. In a great position, too, against the cage. This will really make it harder for Anthony Pettis to work off his back with his head trapped against the cage.
Pettis closes guard on Pawlicewski, and this is something we haven't seen in the fight so far here in round number two. What kind of defense does Anthony Pettis have working off his back?
I think his defense is going to come a lot from his explosive offensive maneuvers he does. It's not so much going to be tying up at Bart Pawlikowski, but the fact that he can fire off some vicious submission attempts here, which, that being the situation, his head being trapped, that's going to nullify a lot of that.
Action, guys. Keep it moving.
Bart's in a good position. He really needs to go ahead and keep it going.
Oh, momentarily.
He needs to get pull his legs out. There he goes. You don't want the bottom guy to have his back against the cage. You want his back against the canvas and his head sitting on the cage. Extremely uncomfortable position to be in from the bottom. And he needs to continue to do so. Now here, though, Bart needs to stay active. You don't want to have the referee come in here and start the fight up in this beautiful position that Bart's in.
Worked hard for it. He dropped his head moments ago. I was going to say, momentarily putting himself at risk at the choke. Postures up.
He needs to not go. A mistake, in my opinion.
Gave up the great
why
position.
Why would you back up on Anthony Pettis? I would stay in that position with anybody in the world to have their back flat on the ground with their head against the cage.
Pawlikowski, though, gaining confidence here as we approach 225 in round number two. This one's scheduled for 3.
Looks like he was going to do another head kick attempt.
Yeah.
Oh, there it goes.
When Pettis goes into that position, Frank, he shows so many different things. It can be a spinning back fist, it can be a kick, straight left.
I think, though, that it would do well right now. He's done some very flashy footwork and maneuvers from the outside. I'd like to see him, get down to the grind a little bit more, throw some combinations, string it together. Be a little bit more basic right now and really dominate if he wants to the stand-up aspect of this fight. Right now, he could almost be losing because, he has large breaks in between these great techniques, and Bart is moving forward methodically with hand combinations and being very aggressive. You don't want to fall asleep here, trying to be too flashy and give up a decision.
Yeah, we saw Bart take his back at the end of round number one. Pettis controlling the wrists.
Bart's going for, again, that Sakuraba type Kimura from the standing position. Anthony is. Bart needs to be leery of it, but, a good position from here, Bart wanted to, is actually to reach between your opponent's legs and lock it up. Oh, that's awesome.
Pettis recognized what Pawlikowski was trying to do. Comes out now striking.
There we go.
What a combination.
That was great because it wasn't just a fancy move. That was solid kickboxing. Jab, cross, switched with the lead kick. But it seems like he goes and scores a few shots, and now he's going back into this mode here, which is, very beautiful and fast. I just worry about the judges, the way they're looking at it. He needs to keep his work rate high. Attempt again. That was an That was so fast and explosive. Bart Pawlikowski is looking at his own heel hook.
Under 10 seconds to go here in round number two. And an inadvertent shot to Pawlikowski will end round two.
I feel good. All right, loosen up one more. The high kicks are there. And the liver kicks there, and the low kick. You got to put it on him. Let's put some showtime in this round, okay? Yep. Loosen up. You know what he's gonna do? Don't overcommit. Fake the punches one more. He's going to clinch. Keep getting on. Okay. Breathe, drink.
Drop his hips behind his thighs. Lift and dump him. Put him down. Don't give him a chance to spin out like this. Keep throwing those hand combinations. Keep pushing him back. Let's keep taking him down, and let's win this fight. All right? Got it? He's going to be coming. He knows he's chasing. He's two rounds down, so we got to pick it up. Best round coming, all right?
This is it. The third and final round in the lightweight division. Bart Pawlikowski and Anthony Pettis.
Hey, not so stupid.
Frank, we heaped the accolades on Anthony Pettis as he came in, but I've got to tell you, I'm very impressed with Bart Pawlikowski. His defense basically answered the call.
He has. He's done a great job of dealing with the fact that he has given up a lot of speed to Anthony Pettis. He's coming forward. Is, you know, he's in this fight. But the guy has 40 fights. How could he not be? You know, you got to figure, hopefully, that his experience and the skill level is extremely high. I mean, the only reason why we're speaking so much about Anthony Pettis is he's the new kid on the block with so much potential. And, you know, Bart's more of a seasoned veteran here in the WEC.
Go under 4 minutes to go, and this the third and final round. Pettis in the black and white trunks, Pawlikowski in the white trunks. Even the speed of his spinning back fist when he missed, pretty impressive.
It is. Like I said, though, I just want to see him get in there now, mix it up. And have a little bit higher of an output rate.
You're talking about more substance, right?
Well, you know, exactly. I mean, he's successful and he's flashy. Like that, there, nice axe kick. He just, output needs to increase, especially since he's moving, you know, backwards. You know, Bart's moving forward.
Pawlikowski catches him with a right. Pettis in a bit of trouble here. He'll lock up Pawlikowski on the ground.
It was a great job of Bart Pawlikowski catching that combination. Anthony Pettis really has to come back now and turn around, right? So far this round, I'm going towards Bart.
No question.
He's come forward, he's thrown more strikes, and he's landed, obviously, the more decisive strike. He's rocked Anthony Pettis, and now he's on the top. Inside his guard, pressed him up against the cage.
The veteran move. Instead of keeping him away from the cage, he just walked him right into it.
So far, you know, Bart has done so flawlessly. The only time I ever disagreed with any of Bart's game plan was when he backed off the cage the last time they were in this position.
He's going to get anxious here with his legs, okay? Inside control.
Back on his feet with Pettis.
Let's see if this woke up Anthony a little bit. He's coming to be more aggressive.
All right, Frank, the final 90 seconds of this fight. If you're in the corner of Anthony Pettis, what are you telling him?
Let's win this round and put this guy away. It's way, you know, do not leave this up to a judge's decision. Let's go out there and throw and show that all the hype is well deserved.
Pawlikowski doing a great job continuing to stalk Pettis. Great defense, surviving all the flashy moves. Under a minute to go, the third and final round. Anthony Pettis in the black and white trunks. Bart Pawlikowski, his opponent.
This fight's been close, and obviously, I won't be surprised if everyone has a decision at this point.
Pawlikowski's in trouble, and Pettis goes to work.
Anthony needed that to equal out the
jump up and brings the knee. Under 20 seconds to go. The final 10 seconds, and this the third and final round.
Oh, that was awesome.
Good fight, guys.
What a contrasting style of fight. This is the flurry towards the end. He catches him with that right.
Right on the chin with the overhand right, but Bart Pavlovski. Shapsky is an extremely tough individual. Been in a lot of wars and was able to instantly recover. And here, this is just unbelievable testament to his athletic ability. You see this in the movies. No one ever actually does that in a fight. That's unbelievable.
Anthony Pettis does. At the end of great three rounds of fighting in the lightweight division, we go inside the cage. Joe Martinez has the official decision.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards here. Are your judges' scoring totals? Judge Dave Hagan scores it 30-27 for Pawlaszewski. Judge Glenn Trowbridge has it 30-27 for Pettis. And Judge Junichiro Camijo scores it 29-28 for your winner by split decision.